Welcome to all dear students. Our today's discussion topic is skill of MSBTE annual exam preparation and paper writing for pharmacy. First of all, I introduce myself. I am Prabodh Sapkale, lecturer at Srimati Sharadchandrika Suresh Patil, Institute of Technology, D Pharmacy, Chopda. My contact details, email ID, prabodhsapkale@gmail.com. So let's discuss our today's topic, and most important factor is your own health. Then our prescribed syllabus, that is ER 91, prescribed by Pharmacy Council of India. Then reading a question paper. After that, think quickly. And also next considerable factor is time limit to cover all required questions. And next one, while paper writing, a most important factor is spelling and grammar. Dear student, so we start from our health. About the health, it is very important to maintain your health in preparation leave period, you can say that PL period, and especially when actual you facing the exam. So what to do while maintaining your health exam in exam period? Take a full rest at night, minimum 6 to 8 hours. Then many of you have a habit to learn up to the late night and wake up in the morning at 9 or 10 a.m. This is very bad habit, so avoid this and plan your study accordingly so you can take a rest at night. Take your breakfast, lunch and dinner properly as you taken in your daily life. What happened when you take extra stress in these days and avoid to take a breakfast, lunch and dinner? It is totally wrong thing. If you have any medical history, and in that case your doctor prescribe any medicine for you, then you don't forget to take a certain medicine. It is also required to maintaining your normal health. Certain time unwanted things are happened and we disturb because of that and take extra stress so that lose our concentration from study. For example, in exam time, without any reason we fought with our friends. So you should ignore this and just concentrate in your study. For refreshment, to refresh your mind, you should take water, tea, coffee or any energy drink to refresh. After refreshment, you can start what you do in your study. Students, along with that, now we discuss about our syllabus study. First of all, try to complete your reading syllabus. Means, suppose in a biochemistry and clinical pathology subject, there are 9 chapters is given. Try to read all the topics and understood it. For this, you plan like this. Divide your syllabus as per sessional syllabus conducted by your college, or you can divide your syllabus as per your convenience and try to read every topics in it. While reading any chapter or topic, you have any query or you can't understand the meaning of it, you can discuss with your study group, that means friend circles. Still your problem is remain same, then discuss it with your subject teacher without any hesitation. I am certain assure to such a students, your faculty member definitely solve your problem. Many students make their own study schedule and try to follow it, but because of any reason, they are unable to cover all the chapter of particular syllabus and miss to cover one of them chapter from syllabus. So, don't think more on it, and not to lose your self-confidence, because all remaining chapter you read properly except one of it. So, don't make phobia of uncovered chapter. If any topic is hard to understand, you give it a special conserved time to that particular topic and try to understand that topic. One more important thing is that student try to memorize without practicing, but certain topics are memorized or understand when they are practice it on a paper, like chemistry structure, biological sources, metabolism cycles, and many more example. In Hindi, it is called as so bar baka or ek bar likha. So try it in your exam, before exam. Now, next about our question paper. When you got your question paper in exam hall, you should read it very carefully within first 5 to 7 minutes only. I think so, 5 to 7 minutes is sufficient for reading your question paper if you have a full concentration over the given question paper. Do not take much more time. If any question is unable to understand, then read it again with proper pronunciation of that word and try to understand that what kind of answer is expected by the examiner. If question paper is too easy that you know all the answer, so keep concentration over writing a paper. Do not excited yourself. Or opposite to it, if question paper is too hard that many answer you are not sure, then keep calm yourself and do not depress, because you have to still remain 2 hours and 55 minutes in your hand. So keep calm and try to remember the answer. So do not leave exam hall and try to solve the whole question paper. Next is think quickly. What do you mean by think quickly? You should think quickly means if you write a definition, you should know the example of that particular definition. While writing an answer briefly, you should think quickly about the content of your answer point wise. And it is only possible when your study is up to mark. If you write an answer and meanwhile you forget further that you have to remember, then do not write an irrelevant matter in that answer. Such a kind of activity lose your paper impression. So you should remember your answer and write down afterwards. Next one is give proper numbering to that answer. Example, if in a question paper sub question is asking in Roman like 1, 2, and 3, this is given in that, then you should indicate answer only in Roman, or if it is given in numericals, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, then you should write down as a numerical one. Many students think that if I write a long answer, then only I got a full mark. But rather than that, you should think likewise. If I am writing a proper contained and point-wise answer, then I got a full marks. Dear students, remember that marks only for the content of that answer, not for the length of that answer. Likewise, 2 pages, 3 pages, etc., etc. Next one, the time limit. You should maintain the time limit as per the marking. Suppose you have to solve 2 mark question, in that you have to solve any 8 or 7 sub questions. You should solve it within 15 to 18 minutes. Likewise, plan your whole 3 hours. Do not leave any question. Try to solve whole question paper. Many students said after completion of paper, I leave out 10 marks or 15 marks paper due to a lack of time. This is called as mismanagement of time. Many students have a habit to solve extra questions also, but at the end they do not complete their whole paper. So do not solve extra question. Try to solve specific question as per demanded in a question paper. After solving whole question paper, then draw a cross full line over a blank pages of answer sheet. Along with that, during exam hour, do not write over a question paper. It will consider as a malpractices. The important topic is grammar and spelling. It is very important part of our paper writing. Students should know about tense, verb, proverb and noun and its correct uses. While writing your answer, consider all these factors. Tense is very important part in a subject like pharmaceutical jurisprudence. You can say that the PJ. Use word properly. That means student use like this. This is the example. Example is taken as a cell definition. In cell definition, many students write like that. When cell is defined as, it is a basic structural and functional unit of body. It's called or known as cell. Cell, when you use the word define, then there is no need to use the word called or known. And if you don't use the word define, then you should the word use called or known. Try to write an answer in your own language which maintain their grammar and spelling. Write a correct spelling. It is extremely important in pharmacy. Read spelling from authorized textbooks or reference books only rather than your notes or any other things. Especially your crude drugs, their families, chemical constituents or active pharmaceutical ingredients names. In now some common topics we write it in a miscellaneous. This is very common things. You like that you use your regular pen instead of special pain, because you have a habit to use regularly and you can maintain your writing speed. So use a regular pen, or you can, if you use a special pen, before using this special pen, then you practice it and then use in your final examination. Many students leave a extra space on right hand side of your answer sheet, but such kind of extra space is irrelevant. There is no need to leave a such space. In MSBT answer sheet, already space line is given on left hand side, but many students along with that line draw one more parallel line in left hand side. It is very irrelevant. Left hand side space given because student can easily indicate the question number and their sub question number. If you rough any wrong sentences, word, structure or formula, then draw a single line over it. Don't scratch over any sentence, word, structure or formula. When you start your main question, like question number 1, question number 2, question number 3 and as on, start it from your main question from new page. So if you draw a diagram, or you can say that the figure, by using a pencil, or do not draw or do not write down a structure by pencil, for drawing any kind of structure you should use a regular pen like black or blue. Use your own exam accessories like pencil, sharpener, eraser, scale, etc. for saving your valuable time at the time of examination. My dear friend, thank you for your attention. Hope you all solve your queries. If any queries, please contact on given mail. I definitely revert the mail with your solution, with the solution of your queries. Thank you. Thanks again.